I had written my dissertation defended it in 45, and I actually finished my chemistry. I got my MSc in chemistry in 46. But of course, by the time the war finished, I had only one idea after being cooped up under German occupation for 4 years in Belgium. I had only one idea: move out and see the world. Well, there's still one episode that maybe I should mention here. In order to get my chemistry degree, I had to do a small thesis on a subject, a small research thesis. And biochemistry was not recognized by the science faculty at the university. They only knew organic, mineral, physical chemistry, three branches. And so I didn't know exactly what to do. I couldn't work on insulin or glucose. That would not have been accepted. And so by chance, one day, walking in Louvain, I met a young man whom I knew slightly. He was a Flemish young doctor who worked in the laboratory of microbiology, bacteriology. And he had been approached by a group of business people and professors, Louvain, who, under the impulse of a man who had a rather big paper factory, wanted to create a new pharmaceutical industry. They wanted to create an industry that would do its own research, not just packing of chemicals, but actually do research. And they had put up the money, or some money, for this, and they had decided that the first thing they would do would be to make penicillin. They had heard, of course, of penicillin because some of the early works on penicillin were, of course, available. Fleming made his discovery in something like 1932, if I remember rightly. And so they wanted to make penicillin. And this young man was, in fact, culturing penicillium notatum, which is the mold that makes penicillin, from which penicillin is extracted. He knew how to assay the bacteriostatic effect of insulin on bacterial cultures, but he wasn't a chemist. He didn't know how to purify. And so he said, well, I want somebody to purify the penicillin. I said, well, that's fine. I'm going to do that. And so my thesis for my chemical degree was to purify penicillin. Well, it turned out that that little work that we did together, the man was called Piet De Somer, that we did together led to the creation of a new company, which is called R.I.T. And R.I.T. grew because of my friend. He really developed this company. They made vaccines, polio vaccine, they made other antibiotics, they made a number of very important developments. So the company grew. Eventually the company was bought by an American company, SmithKline French. SmithKline French was eventually bought by Glaxo, and Glaxo was eventually called by bought by Beecham, or maybe it's the other way around, I forget. But anyway, this little company, if it blossomed into finally becoming a part of one of the biggest pharmaceutical industries in the world, Glaxo GBK, or BGK, Beecham, Glaxo, something like that. They have a big, in fact, in Belgium, they have a very big research labs and manufacturing facilities right here. So I was actually involved in this little adventure. But when the war finished, I decided, no, I don't want to go into industry. I want to go back to insulin, and I want to become a scientist, to do so-called pure science.